leads at 9.8 to take the lead from Mary Lou Retton. And it may be the last big international appearance for Kat.
And what an inspiration to all of us that have watched her growth through the years. She's an inspiration to all those young gymnasts coming up as well. This has been an event that has been her best and her worst. When she's on, she is just beautiful on this event. Tremendous grace. Plus, she has the difficulty coming up right now. Her gainer back layout, and she is on. I think Kathy's going to be on this entire routine, it looks like, so far. And she saves that back walk of her back layout. Really no bobble. Her arms are just a little sharp coming up. Here's a difficult move. It's straddle jump. Shoulders, hips, and legs have to be in line. Very good, and believe me, that is a difficult move to do on the beam. It's a blind move. You cannot see where you're landing. Handstand now. Complete split. Toe tap. Legs together. A move that she has done so smoothly over the years. Back roll extensions. Kathy looks on. Looking back like that is also risky. Actually, a side leap. If she can continue this way, this is the best routine I've seen Kathy do. What a way to finish!
Yes.
The highlight of her life, right in front of her. What a way to end.
If that indeed is her final performance, what a swan song. Big hug from Coach Peters. Yes. Tears of joy.
She has done so very much for this sport in the United States.
Julianne McNamara, Mary Lou Retton. Here is that dismount again.
And as we said, you can't do it better. Kathy was right on. Cartwheel here. She lands, or actually a round off. She lands both feet. She's directly over the balance beam, just where she wants to be. And on her landing, no movement.
Kathy Johnson, now we all await with her this score, which she's anticipating to be a full one.
And you know, I don't think it matters to her really what the score is. She has done the best routine of her life. All the times we've watched her, this was excellent.
That's what this is. Just do your best.
That's right.
And we have had a lot of difficulty in terms of time here with the scoring. I've seen that they've been unfair, but they've had taken their time and putting it up. 9.85 for Kathy Johnson. And the crowd here does not. The polka of Romania. She was leading coming into this event.
And she's been absolutely brilliant on this event. That can swing right into two back layouts. She takes away the effect that there's a balance beam underneath her. And that's one of the things the judges look for. They want you to work like you're on the floor exercise mat, and yet that beam is 4 inches wide. Aggressive worker, right into a back layout, and she makes it more difficult by landing on with her feet together. Not much room on that beam.
I see, I've got narrow feet to do that, don't
yes.
you?
Yes, she taps her toe, comes back, showing her flexibility. There's an interesting move. You have to make sure that your hips and shoulders are right over that beam, otherwise it'll throw you right off. But whenever you're grasping the beams with your hands, it's easier to stay in control. It's the aerial moves that get you into trouble.
Mm-hmm.
As she's preparing for right now. Back walkover, back handspring, two in a row, and a double twist.
Oh, yes.
Excellent routine.
Simona Pałka leading coming in here, and she throws a good one.
No breaks in her routine, Jack. Ekaterina, Bravo.
Who's up next?
Bravo. great view. This is the view the gymnast has of the balance beam. You can see that you really try to line yourself up, and on her back handspring back layout, she was directly over the top on both of them. In fact, when you're standing right over like that, you can't even see her legs. And here's another back handspring into her double leg layout where she lands with both feet together. And her dismount. What an intricate movements here. This is a tumbling series or acrobatic series. They have to have three seed moves, which are the most difficult of all the moves, and she has all of them.
9-9-0, Kathy, and that puts her in the lead ahead of Kathy Johnson and Mary Lou Retton. As we come up now to a Katarina Szabo, who was in second place coming in here.
She received a perfect 10 in the all-around competition. Of course, that doesn't count going into this meet, and here's her planche. Look at the flexibility and the strength.
9-9-5 to tie for the gold medal, with 10 to take it.
The Romanians have been so mentally strong on this event. They are aggressive. They go out there and they do the job. They may fall, but they never hesitate. Four back handsprings in a row. She actually only gets credit for the three back handsprings. The fourth is for just a little extra originality and showmanship there. I think more so for the audience. This competition, as we said in the beginning, it's important to go all out and not to hold back or be under too much control. Back handspring back layout, no bobbles, no hesitations. Sort of a Valdez there in her split. She moves quickly. It seems the high scores on this event come from the quick paced routine that we've seen so far. Look at this side scale. Talk about control. They're all settling down into the competition a lot more. Round up, double back. They look very confident up on the beam.
Kati Szabo, Romania. Another brilliant performance. Everybody's been quite impressed, not only with their talent, but of their manner and their, the way they conduct themselves. And the Romanians have done themselves a lot of good here.
And you should see them in the gym. They're just, they smile, they talk to everybody. There's her four back handsprings. And you can see the lineup there. Now, it's important not to hesitate before any movement, but they do take a little breath, as long as it's not too long, before they go into the moves. This back handspring into a layout, once again, was straight on.
It's a 9-9-5. And she will be tied now with Palka for the gold. So the two Romanian girls, Szabo and Palka, get the gold. Kathy Johnson of the United States gets the bronze. More exercise.
Had a very high compulsory score of 9.8, which just goes to show that, her basics in dance are right on. Her tumbling is very good also. A triple twist, and she's all the way around on it. Maha's had to build up strength along with her flexibility. It's good to be flexible. If you don't have the strength to go along with it, though, it's impossible to do some of the more difficult elements on tumbling. She smiled at the judge there in the corner. Half twist, front flip, into another one. Showing a little bit of front tumbling. Very lyrical arm movements. Right before the last tumbling run.
Deep breath.
ankle twist. Good routine.
Mayan Hong.
We didn't see any double back saltos, which is not necessary, except that the general impression with some of the other routines you were seeing, it's a good thing to have. But she does have the triple twist in the very beginning, as we see right here. And this is important to get high and to keep your direction going well. It's easy to get off balance here and just twist right into the ground. So your feet are crossed a little bit there. She gets 2 3/4 away.
Waiting for her score now. She's very strong. She couldn't be that good on the uneven bars if she wasn't strong.
No, but she's also so flexible in her back that sometimes it's difficult to keep it tight when you need to be tight, especially in those tumbling moves.
Mary Lou Retton will be next.
And we all know what Mary Lou is capable of. She's a bundle of dynamite.
And loves the floor exercise. There's Ma.
It's interesting, those things she has around her feet. I'm not really sure what they're for, except that they show her legs together all the time. Maybe she's trying to accentuate that point to the judges.
Well, there seems to be a little difficulty here on the score of Mayan Hong. There it is. 9-7-0.
We didn't see any big breaks in the routine, so that must have been the general impression. No back tucks.
So leading right now is Zhou Churi of China, and Mary Lou needs a 9.75 to take that lead. This ought to be exciting.
And unless she falls, that should be no problem. Explosive, fastest and strongest legs in the competition. She begins with a double layout. And as we've said in the past, there aren't too many people in the competition doing this move. And she explodes. Stepped out of bounds there, though. That's a tenth of a point. That's why it's so important not to run too far into the middle of the mat. Here's a full-in double back. It's a double back flip with a twist on the first back somersault. And she was definitely on there, right into a front flip. Has them exactly where she wants them. And once again, she will defy gravity with her double back. She just doesn't want to come down.
All right, Mary Lou Retton, one break, but she only got my spot.
A little bittersweet smile there for that one movement.
On super slow motion, let's take a look now at the first tumbling move.
This is such a difficult element, a double layout. The body is straight all the way around. She ran a little bit far, possibly, because she certainly was on the layout. She wasn't traveling too far. She did exactly what she always does, goes up in the air. Look at the second one rise. That first one gives them the momentum, and then the second one pulls up just slightly. And there you'll see she stepped right out there, just slightly.
There it is, out of bounds, in the white.
And that judge on the corner certainly saw it.
Well, there's a familiar couple, Bela, the coach. What an Olympics he's had.
Oh.
He's made a big vault from Transylvania to Houston, Texas, but everybody in the world will be beating it past to his gymnasium. Let's see, we've got 9.85 from Mary Lou Retton on the floor exercise, and we'll be back with more Olympic action in just a moment. It's a 9.85 to take the lead from Mary Lou Retton.
She's been spectacular on this event and must feel quite accomplished to be ahead of Mary Lou. She was leading coming into this competition.